So this right here is probably going to be a separate video now or something like an outtake, because I probably added a shitty meme over this partial fraction decomposition because people are tired of this. I am too, but we have to do it. So for the guys interested in this process, I'm going to explain it a little bit. Okay, so we want to decompose this into two new fractions, the sum of two new fractions, because we have two factors here. And the great thing is, both factors are dependent on x squared. So you could also say x squared is equal to some u. That means we have factors of the first order. So we don't really need some as plus b up here. We just need constant terms a plus b. And now we can multiply both sides by this big denominator because it's not equal to zero. And what we end up with is just that 1 equals 2. And now we have a s squared plus 4 ax squared. And also we have this times that. That makes plus bx squared plus b. And this polynomial on this side has a degree of 2. But this polynomial has a degree of 0, so we want to make this also a degree of 0. How can we achieve that? Well, we want to get rid of everything that's higher than degree 0. So for example, this right here. So we can observe that 4a plus b must be 0. Because we have those x squared terms, but well, let's just cancel them out. We can do it not equal to 0. And we can conclude that b is now equal to minus 4a. So that's quite nice. We can plug this in. This and that we cancel out basically. And what we have now is that 1 equals to as squared minus 4a. We can factor out this a. So now it's a times s squared minus 4. And well, dividing both sides by s squared minus 4, not equal to 0, is going to leave us with a equals to 1 over s squared minus 4. And now we can plug this into the condition for b. So that also means that b is now equal to minus 4 over s squared minus 4. And then we are done with the partial fraction decomposition and we can plug everything in. Here we go again for the highly interested people of you guys. Let's do the partial fraction decomposition. So this time we can't use this little substitution trick on here because we have something of the first order and something of the second order right here. So let's just do regular partial fraction decomposition. So once again, two factors, we have to end up with the sum of two new fractions. And also this time, this has a degree of 2 right here in the denominator, so we have to end up with a polynomial of degree 1 in the numerator. So let's just keep that in mind. And now we can multiply both sides by this big denominator once again. So that's now equivalent to saying we have as squared minus 4a, and then plus bs squared plus cs is equal to 1. S squared right here. So we have this polynomial. Once again, we want to get a degree of 0 on this side too, because this side has a degree of 0. Okay, so you might notice we only have one term right here that includes a degree of 1. So c is supposed to be 0 in this case. So c needs to be 0. That's quite nice. This simplifies a bit. And also, just like before, we have those s squared terms. Well, that's quite nice. Because a needs to be minus b. Bringing this to the other side. So a plus b has to be 0 is equivalent to saying we have a equals to minus b. I hope you can see where this comes from. My explanation is a bit sloppy on those partial fraction decomposition videos. Never mind. So what do we end up with now? We know that this is 0, this is 0, this is 0. So we now know that minus 4a needs to be 1. But we can conclude, since minus 4 isn't equal to 0, that a needs to be minus 1 over 4. Well, we have a condition for b. B is just minus a. So that also means that b is 1 over 4. Done. So next partial fraction decomposition. We have this right here, and now we can use the substitution trick once again. Multiplying both sides by this big denominator will leave us with, so we now have 1 is equal to as squared minus 4a plus bs squared. Same situation as before, a needs to be minus b, a equals to minus b, and well, just like before, that now means that 1 is equal to minus 4 times a. Multiplying both sides by minus 1 over 4 will leave us with a equals to minus 1 over 4. Plugging this into the condition for b is going to give us that b is equal to 1 over 4. And now we can plug everything in. And don't forget up here that this b has a factor of s up here in the numerator. Don't forget that.